I want to go over just briefly the FDA categories for drugs as they relate to pregnant women. There are a series of different categories that the FDA has created when it describes drugs for use for women who are currently pregnant. And we want to go through the criteria used for giving a drug a particular category. So we'll just begin then with category A. So these are drugs that have well-controlled studies on pregnant women, and those well-controlled studies on pregnant women show no risk, no possible elevation of risk to the pregnant woman during any trimester of her pregnancy. There is no harm to the unborn baby, there is no harm to the mother. So category A drugs related to pregnancy are drugs that have well-controlled studies on pregnant women that indicate no elevated risk to the mother or to the unborn child. Category B drugs are drugs that have had clinical trials related to animals, and in those trials related to animals, there have been no adverse effects on the animal fetuses. It is also possible in B category drugs that there have been animal studies that do show adverse effects on the animal fetuses, and yet studies on pregnant women don't show any adverse effects. So a category B is they've done an animal study and no well-controlled studies on pregnant women, or they've done animal studies that show some adverse effect on unborn animal fetuses, and yet in the women's studies they've done, there was no adverse effect on unborn babies. So in this category then, you've got not well-controlled, no risk, but animal studies, no adverse effects, animal studies with adverse effects, but women's studies that corroborate that there were no adverse effects on the unborn babies. All right, category C, this category includes animal studies that do show adverse effects, but there are no studies on pregnant women available. So this would be sort of a subset of B in a way. Remember, B included animal studies that did show adverse effect on unborn animal fetuses, yet the pregnant women's studies showed no adverse effect. Category C would be they have the animal studies but no pregnant women's studies to go along with that. So category C is there are animal studies showing adverse effect, no studies on pregnant women. Also drugs that have no clinical trials whatsoever for animals or humans would fall into category C as well. Finally, category D then, as we work our way A through D, and then we'll get to X last, but when we get to D, under D, there are well-controlled studies on pregnant women that show an elevated risk factor for the unborn baby. So well-controlled studies on pregnant women that do show risk to the unborn baby and possibly to the pregnant woman. But these have indicated that there is risk to the unborn child. Finally, then, at the very end is category X. Category X includes all drugs that have well-controlled studies of both women, pregnant women, and animals, and those drugs have actually done physical harm to the unborn animals and the unborn babies. So in this case, well-controlled studies, both women and animals, that indicate actual positive harm to the fetus. And so definitely category X is a problem. But A through D is basically a continuum, A being those that are, according to the FDA, at no risk whatsoever to the unborn baby, B, no adverse effects in humans, but primarily animal studies. C, the animals, there was risk, but there's no pregnant women studies to go along with it, or no studies at all. D, well-controlled studies showing the possibility, an elevated risk of harm. And X, well-controlled studies proving actual positive harm to the unborn baby. These are then the classifications that the FDA has put together for drug categories related to women and pregnancy.